Did Trump's inaugural team funnel money to Trump? ProPublica reporting tonight that the Trump Organization may have overcharged Trump's own inaugural committee for all kinds of things, rooms, meals, event space at Trump's hotel in Washington, D.C. during the inauguration. And we're talking about an incredible amount of money here. The person in the middle of the negotiations, Ivanka Trump. This breaking news coming just one day after the New York Times reported the inaugural committee is under criminal investigation for possibly taking illegal foreign donations. So that's the money coming in, and now this new reporting on the money going out. Out front now, one of the ProPublica reporters who broke the story, Justin Elliott, and former ethics lawyer for President George W. Bush, Richard Painter, who worked with President Bush on the second inauguration and was the one in charge of making sure that everything was, the rules were followed. So, Justin, let me start with all this reporting that you have. Okay. You have never before reported evidence here tonight that is part of this story of how much the Trump Organization was overcharging, right? And in one case, you're talking about $100,000 a day for space at the Trump Hotel in Washington, right?
Yeah, so what we know is, what we didn't know before is that the inaugural committee actually spent a significant amount of money with the Trump Hotel, Trump giving money essentially to Trump himself. Right. What we also know, my colleague...
Which, by the way, in and of itself would be problematic to a lot of people, but...
Yeah, extremely unusual
in and of itself. Then you're saying on top of that...
So my colleague from WNYC and I published emails showing that a top planner in the inaugural committee expressed concerns to several people, including Ivanka Trump, saying the rate that the Trump Hotel is trying to charge the inaugural committee is way too high, and essentially she said this is not going to look good when it becomes public. They were proposing to charge $175,000 a day for a ballroom rental in the Trump Hotel down in Washington. We also didn't know that Ivanka Trump was involved in some kind of pricing negotiation between the inaugural committee on one hand and her company, the Trump Organization, on the other.
And let's just be clear, this top event planner, Stephanie Winston-Wolkoff, she was saying $175,000 is out of control. 85 is what I would propose. I mean, just to give people a sense of how out of whack this was.
Right. And it's not clear where they ended up. It's also not clear the total amount of money the Trump Organization ultimately got. But, another issue here is if they were overcharged, it could actually be a violation of tax law. Because Trump was an influential person in the inaugural committee, he's not allowed. His business is not allowed to be overcharging the inaugural committee for services. So there could actually be a legal violation.
And Ivanka Trump, you're saying, was in the middle, right? When there were these complaints about pricing, she's the one who came in between the person complaining and the hotel, correct?
She's on the emails. Rick Gates, who is another figure in Trump world who's since pleaded guilty to conspiracy and lying, says in one of the emails, "Thank you, Ivanka, for the help on this."
All right, so we learned last night the inaugural committee is also under criminal investigation, right? This is the foreign donors, the money coming in. The president's spokesperson responded, Sarah Sanders. She says this has absolutely nothing to do with Trump himself. Here she is.
That doesn't have anything to do with the president or the first lady. The biggest thing the president did in his engagement in the inauguration was to come here and raise his hand and take the oath of office.
Not true. You report, right, that he was repeatedly briefed on inaugural planning, which should surprise no one because this is the kind of thing that he loves to do. You actually have seen presentations that he was given. We're talking room renderings, whatever, floral arrangements. I mean, he knew what was going on.
Yeah, I mean, and even before that, Donald Trump personally selected the people running the inaugural committee. At the top of it, his friend Tom Barrack, a wealthy businessman and fundraiser. Yep. And then during the planning process, there are presentations that my colleague and I have seen showing we're going to rent this room, this is what it looks like, in this building, this is where we're going to have a luncheon, this is where we're going to have a ball, that were delivered to Donald Trump himself.
All right, well, let me bring Richard Painter in here. Richard, I mean, what's your reaction to this reporting?
Well, it's a terrible situation. In the Bush administration, we kept very close tabs on the inaugural committee, even months after the inauguration, to make absolutely sure there was no self-dealing with those funds, no favorable treatment of government officials. We made sure the government officials didn't even get special souvenirs from the inauguration. Because when you take funds for personal use out of a nonprofit, that's like taking money out of a church collection plate or the treasurer of a nonprofit, just skimming money off for himself or herself. That could be a crime. People go to jail for that, and then you have the tax implications. And furthermore, we're dealing with government officials here.
Right.
And it's absurd to say that the president doesn't know what's going on. The president is on top of this situation.
And let me just, Richard, you know, when this comes, you're talking about the money going out of Justin's reporting. Now, also, you know, he's talking about that we now know the criminal investigation right on donors. We know that they raised $107 million from donors, and that's what prosecutors are now looking at. But of that $107 million, we to this day do not know where $40 million of it went. $40 million bucks, we have no idea where it went. How's that possible?
And that's shocking. Somebody's stealing money. Somebody's put money in their own pocket. $40 million unaccounted for. We elected a president who said, well, I'm a successful businessman. Well, we knew there were a lot of problems there. But $40 million unaccounted for, that is a telltale sign of fraud. Something's going on here. Criminal activity is very likely. If we had seen any amount of money missing in the Bush inaugural committee, I would have called people into my office and said, I want to find out exactly where that money is. Better find out fast, because it could be a crime, what's going on here.
All right. And there is a criminal investigation, as we said, just on the donations. And now with this reporting, you know, we see what happens here on the spending.